Should you be avoiding sugar at all costs? Or is it an essential part of your diet? For the answer to this question, stay tuned, because in this video, we will cover the pros and cons of sugar and give our conclusion on whether sugar is a worthy addition to your diet. Make sure to watch this video till the end, because we'll also cover some of the biggest myths on sugar that you surely misconceived as facts up until this day. What's going on, people? It's the Healthy Penguins here, back at it again with another video. And in this video, we'll tell you all there is to know about sugar. We'll give you an in-depth breakdown of the pros and cons, and some helpful advice on how to be able to consume sugar while avoiding its drawbacks. We'll start with the basics. What is sugar? Sugar is a sweet substance that belongs to the carbohydrates. This is also evident from its molecular structure, which is comprised of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen molecules. And don't be mistaken, sugar is in many, many different places. If you happen to be in the kitchen, just take a look around. Maybe there's some cookies nearby. They obviously contain sugar. Or maybe you've got a jar of straight up granulated sugar. But there could also be any kind of fruit, which definitely contains sugar. And how about a cookbook? Those pages also contain sugar. And the milk you have in the fridge? Yep, contains sugar as well. As you can tell, sugar is present in many different kinds of food, but also in non-food products. This is also part of the reason why our bodies can't function without sugar, which is what we'll get into right now. We've probably all heard the statement that it's better not to consume any sugar at all, and I'm happy to tell you that that statement is false. Our body cannot function without sugar. You need glucose as a fuel source, enabling you to think and move. Even though there is a negative paradigm on sugars, it is an essential fuel source for our bodies. This negative paradigm originates from the fact that we often consume too much sugar. The sugar we need can be derived from a regular, healthy eating pattern, including sources like fruit, dairy, and even different kinds of vegetables. So don't bother trying to avoid all forms of sugar, because of two reasons. One, sugars are present in so many different kinds of food. It would be unhealthy to avoid all of these. Two, sugar is essential for our bodies to function. But why exactly is sugar so essential? Let's take a look. Sugar consists of glucose and fructose. Your liver will process this glucose and fructose. Fructose will be transformed into fuel, and glucose can be temporarily stored as glycogen. This glycogen storage acts as an energy buffer for when your body requires a quick boost of energy. Some examples are a long bike ride or when you haven't eaten for a while. But sugar is also related to dangerous conditions like type 2 diabetes. How does this work, you wonder? Well, sugar in and of itself is not bad for your health, because in the end, your body needs a source of energy to function properly. And sugar is a very efficient source of energy. However, when you take in too much sugar, you may start to experience some of its drawbacks. Like mentioned previously, too much sugar can lead to overweight and consequently type 2 diabetes. Furthermore, it can cause damage to your teeth and intestines and make you feel more tired. But diabetes type 2 and overweight are by far the most dangerous. Let us show you why. Diabetes is the 7th biggest cause of premature death in the US, and roughly 90 to 95% of all cases of diabetes are type 2. Even though type 2 diabetes is mostly found in people over age 45, there are also more and more children, teens, and young adults who develop it. The National Diabetes Statistics Report of 2020 found that 34.2 million Americans have diabetes. That's just over 1/10 of the American population. Moreover, 88 million American adults are in a state of pre-diabetes, implying that they are in great risk of developing actual diabetes. The scary thing is, diabetes is hard to recognize, but the symptoms are as follows. Being very thirsty and having a dry mouth. Having to pee a lot. Being tired all the time. Irritated eyes, which can present itself in the form of red eyes with a burning sensation. Your vision might turn blurrier or just worsen overall. Your wounds don't heal as quickly as they normally should. You can be short of breath. You can have a painful sensation in your legs when walking. And finally, you experience reoccurring infections like a bladder infection, for example. Even though these symptoms might seem obvious at this moment, most people don't notice them until days, weeks, or even years later. So if you're unsure as to whether you have or are in risk of developing diabetes type 2, make sure to check in with your general practitioner. In order to diagnose type 2 diabetes, they will take a blood sample and conduct a blood sugar test. This test has to be conducted on an empty stomach, so 8 hours in advance of the test, you're not allowed to eat or drink anything but water. When the results of the test shows a blood sugar concentration of over 6 mmol per liter of blood, you are unfortunately diabetic. Let's say you found out you're diabetic. How would this be treated? Well, in order to treat type 2 diabetes, your highest priority should be to shift towards a healthier lifestyle. Exercise and a healthy diet are essential in the treatment process. Most likely, your doctor will also prescribe you medicines that lower your blood sugar, blood pressure, and cholesterol. In some rare cases, you'll also have to inject yourself with insulin. But of course, prevention is always better than remediation. So how do you know how much sugar you can actually take in? The World Health Organization stated an official guideline of 50 grams of sugar per day for adult women, and adult men can take in slightly more at 60 grams per day. However, do keep in mind this guideline is meant for added sugars only. So this includes all forms of sugars that would normally not be found in a healthy diet. So sugars that are already present in fruits or vegetables do not count towards this guideline. Now even though sugar is not bad for you per se, too much of it can be harmful. In general, it is advised to try not to consume as many products with added sugars. For example, instead of soda or fruit juice, try and opt for water, tea, or coffee, without sugar of course. Your main goal should be to derive your energy from foods that naturally contain sugar like fruit, vegetables, and dairy products. To close off the video, we'll cover 3 of the most prominent myths on sugar and tell you if they're actually true or not. So let's get into it. The first myth is as follows. Sugar from fruit is healthier than granulated sugar. False. There are no healthy and unhealthy sugars. Your body will not make a distinction between added sugars or sugars that are naturally present in your food. The second myth. A glass of apple juice contains more than 6 sugar cubes. True. A glass of 250 milliliters of apple juice contains over 20 grams of sugar. This is only slightly less than in a Coke, for example. And finally, myth number 3 reads, sugar will cause you to develop diabetes. This is actually false. Sugar does not directly contribute to the development of diabetes. However, sugar can cause extensive weight gain, which in turn does lead to a higher chance on diabetes type 2. I'm afraid that's it for the video, guys. We from the Healthy Penguins hope this gave you a better understanding of sugar, how it's necessary for our bodies to function properly, and how overconsumption can have harmful effects. If you still have questions or thoughts on sugar, let us know in the comments. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the like and the subscribe buttons below. It helps out the channel a ton. If you didn't enjoy this video, let us know why. We're always looking to improve the quality of our videos to help you learn more about food in the most entertaining and informative way possible. On that note, this is the end of the video. Hope to see you soon. Healthy Penguins, signing out.